Okay, so in question, one cube is given and all these sides of cube carry register R. Like for example, this is numbering is given. Just a minute. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And all this line like 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, they carry equal resistance R. Okay. So we have to find out what is resistance across this terminal 1, 2. Okay. This terminal we have to find out resistor means in short what is R A B equivalent resistance across A B. So before solving such type of circuit we have to find out symmetry in the circuit. Okay, now just take an example. If we'll connect one battery, so how current will flow? So if we'll define direction of current properly, then you can solve this question easily. So suppose some amount of current is coming and at this point it will find a junction. Okay, means current get divided into three part. It gets divided into three part. Now this is this current is going directly to negative terminal of battery. Suppose x amount of current is flowing from this part. Okay, now look at side 1 to 5 and 1 to 4. Okay, and then 5 to 6, so here 4 to 3, and then 6 to 2, then 3 to 2, means they will follow same exact path. Okay, even at 5, if you look at 5, again current get divided into two branches. It means there is symmetry here. In case of 4, point number 4, current get divided into two branches. Okay, so it means current, this is what symmetry. Now if I will suppose I will assume that y amount of current is flowing through this wire 1 to 5, then same amount of current will flow from 1 to 4. Okay, and if now again this y amount of current again find the junction and gets divided, so what will happen? I have to assume that suppose out of y z amount of current will go in this direction. So here I can write y minus z amount of current will flow through branch 4 to 8. So even here, if this is j, because it is symmetric, same resistance, all the resistors is of same value. So it means what? If this is current, j amount of current is flowing through this 4 to 3, then 5 to 6 follow same amount of current. So this is what z. So again, this becomes, see, y amount of current is coming here 1 to 5. So it means, and out of y, z is going here. Then what you will get? Y minus z. Now see, from this side, y minus z current is coming. Then here, y minus z current is coming. So this will be 2y minus z. Now this amount of current will come in the branch 8 to 7. And again, at 7, it will find a junction. So out of 2y minus z, since both the resistors are same value, means 7 to 6 and 7 to 3. So this will be y minus z, and this 7 to 6 also y minus z, because it is 2y minus z, so half of gets divided. Okay, now see, it means how much current is going through the battery. So it means, see, this is x and this is y plus y. It means x plus 2 y amount of current is flowing through the battery, and at junction 1 they gets divided. Now we have to see whether we are getting x plus 2 y amount of current at this point, because the according to Kirchhoff's law, amount of continuity equation, jitna current ja raha hai utna hi current battery mein aayega. There is, because of, this is the conservation of charge. Okay, so now see, At point number 2, 3 lines are connected. Okay, that is 6 to 2, 3 to 2 and 1 to 2. Now, if I will calculate total amount of current in these three branches, and if it is coming x plus 2y, it means your direction of current, your assumptions are correct. Now, let's see. See here, y minus z current is coming at point number 6. And from here, point number 5, z amount of current is coming to 6. So, y minus z plus z. So, you will get y. I am writing here y minus z, minus z plus z cancel. So, you will get basically y. So, this is y amount of current is coming. Okay. Now, look at this branch y minus z. This amount of current is coming at point 3. Okay. And from here, 0.4 z amount of current. Same you will get here. So you will get y amount of current. So and x is also coming here. So x plus 2y, it means your assumption is correct. And now you can solve this circuit to find equivalent resistance. Okay. So to find RAB, we will apply Kirchhoff's law, Kirchhoff's voltage law. So applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. In loop, now loop we have to select. So suppose I am taking loop 4 8 7 7 3, not so that will not complete loop. So 4 to 8 8 to 7 7 to 3, and 3 to again 4. Now 4 4, it means loop is complete. Now apply KVL. So if we are moving, we will move from 4 to 8. So what we will get? So according to Kirchhoff's law, Y minus Z into R. This is amount of current I and resistance is R. Each branch has R resistance. So Y minus Z into R. And then 8 to 7. See, 8 to 7 we have to go. So 8 to 7. So plus, see, direction of current and direction of transversal is same. So plus sign will come. So 2y minus z into r. And again here from 7 to 3. So plus y minus z into r. Okay. And 3 to 4. Now see, z amount of current is going in this direction, but you are moving opposite to the direction of z amount of current. So it will, negative sign will come, minus z r is equal to 0. Now see, y minus z into r, and this is 2y minus z into r, and this is again y minus z into r. It means 2 plus 1, 3 plus 4. It means I can write here 4y minus z into R is equal to ZR. This term will go right side, so it becomes ZR. Okay, don't do this. Let me write minus sign only because we need that. Minus ZR is equal to 0. So solve this equation. 4y minus 4z, this will be R, and here it will be R. Minus z r is equal to 0. So therefore I can write minus 4z r minus z r. It means 4y r minus 5z r is equal to 0. It means 4y r is equal to 5z r. R r get cancelled. So you will get y is equal to 5/4z. This we got y. Now we have to find out x. So you have to select any loop in which you will find x. So see, so either you can select, just either you can select this loop. See, the x is coming, or you can select this 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. So x is coming. So students, see, idea behind collecting the loops, we can find out the value of y and x. Okay. So now see, I'm writing here. Now in loop 4 3 z sorry 4 3 2 it's 2 mera 2 aur z mein thoda confusion hai don't get confused it's 2 this point is 2 na 4 3 2 1 4 now apply so 4 to 3 z r 3 to 2 plus y r then 2 to 1 minus x r then 1 to 4 plus y r is equal to 0 KVL remember KVL Kirchhoff voltage law now solve this so this is y r this is y r okay so it means I can write x r will go that side you will get y r 2 y r plus z r now substitute from this equation I can write one more equation z is equal to 4 by 5 y so that we can put the z so x r is equal to 2 y r yahan par r rahega plus what is value of z 4 by 5 r okay now solve this equation So, ये 5 to 10 means ये 14 this is 2 y r and 4 by 5 y r it means this will be 14 y r divided by 5 is equal to x r this r will get cancelled which implies that x is equal to 14 by 5 y so we got value of x we got value of y now you can see here suppose r dash is the total equivalent resistance r dash is equivalent resistance which we want to find out equivalent resistance now look at point 1 2 so potential difference across 1 2 potential difference across 1 2 is equal to xr likh sakta hu main suppose ye battery ka voltage bhi hai isme confusion nahi hona chahiye see jitna bhi voltage hoga wo pura yahi par derive hoga jo v amount of battery ka jo voltage hai wo in dono point ke beech mein aayega acha aap isko prove bhi kar sakte ho okay maine yahan par prove kiya hai let me show you see See same equation I have proved here. Suppose you will if you will apply KVL in 1 4 3 2 1. See 1 4 3 2 1. इस equation apply करने के बाद हम लोग को ये मिला V equal to 2 I R plus Z R. And then in loop 1 4 3 2 1. So in loop okay. So Y R plus Z R plus Y R means 2 1. यहाँ पर 1 2 ये V होगा. तो इसमें हमने अप्लाई किया सी फॉलो द पाथ ऑफ कर्सर तो 1 4 3 2 एंड वी एंड 1 दिस इज वाज द फर्स्ट एंड देन 1 4 3 2 1 मींस 1 4 3 2 1 दोनों इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करोगे आप एक बार पॉज करके वीडियो पॉज करके सॉल्व करना आपको मिलेगा v इक्वल टू x r सी v इक्वल टू x r यू आर गेटिंग हियर ओके सो दैट्स व्हाट सो बेसिकली पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस across 1 2 we can write xr now potential difference means v battery ka voltage is equal to xr or battery kya hoga v suppose e I v is equal to ir according to ohm's law and r dash equivalent resistance is equal to xr okay how much amount of current we assume x plus 2y so instead of I total current is what x plus 2y x plus 2y R dash is equal to X R. Now X put the value of X. X is nothing but 14 by 5 Y. इसको X ही रहने दो, because it will right hand side में X है हमारा, so that will get cancelled. So you will find out R. Now see. x plus 2y. And from this equation we can write what is y. Y is equal to 5x by 14. Okay. So I can write here 2 and instead of y into 5x x by 14 is equal to x into r. Okay. Now solve this. So you will get value of x. So solve this, you will get, so this is x plus 2 into 5, so I'm writing here. So x plus 10x by 14 is equal to x r. Okay, so therefore 14x plus 10x by 14 is equal to x r. And here is r dash, don't forget. So this is what basically r dash. So 14 plus 10, 24. 24 by 14 x r dash is equal to x r, sorry, not r. Okay, so you can write x r, so x get cancelled and this will give you what, three, 12 or yeah, 7. So r dash is equal to means 12 by 7 r dash is equal to r, which implies that r dash is equal to, implies that r dash is equal to 7 by 12 r. This is your answer. So this was the solution. See, there is a shortcut method also, I will tell you, but first we will understand the concept. Okay, by applying Kirchhoff's law we solve this. Okay, when you are very habitual to use Kirchhoff's law, then this question can be solved very easily. But basic concept is to find out symmetry. The symmetry is in this branch y and this branch means 1 to 4 and 1 to 5 branch. So if you give proper direction to the current, then easily you can solve it. Or another method is that you can simplify the circuit. Now how to simplify? See, जितना करंट यहां से जाएगा और उस फिर उतना ही यहां से भी जाएगा. सी, ओके, बिकॉज अगेन यहां से देखो ये दो ब्रांच डिवाइड हो रहा है और रेजिस्टेंस सबका सेम है. ओके, सो इट मींस व्हाट, उतना ही करंट यहां से भी जाएगा. इट मींस ये पॉइंट 4 और 5 नंबर का पॉइंट जो है वो इक्विपोटेंशियल है. जितना करंट यहां से डिवाइड होगा उतना करंट यहां से डिवाइड होगा 6 के लिए जाएगा. जितना 4 से 3 के लिए उतना 5 से 6 के लिए, जितना 4 टू 8 से 8 के लिए उतना 5 टू 8 के लिए. सो बेसिकली दे आर इक्विपोटेंशियल और उनको आप सर्किट को छोटा करते जाओगे तो आपको वही आंसर मिलता है. ओके, ओके, सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट total diagonal potential, total resistance, equivalent resistance across the complete diagonal, means in this diagram from 1 to 7 if I'll connect battery, so how much is the total resistance this circuit will offer to the battery. Okay, so now see, if when current will reach at this point, it will find a junction. Now see, this much current, some amount of current will flow here, some amount of current will flow here, some amount of current will flow. then again here again it will find junction, okay, and here is the same junction even here, okay. It means all these points are equipotential, means 0.4, 2, 5 are equipotential. So it means equal amount of current gets distributed in this circuit, okay. So now suppose I, for sake of simplicity, I assume that total 3i current will flow from the battery, and so that symmetrically they will get divided into I. So let's go to the branch number 1 to 4. So 1 to 4, what is written here? See, when I amount of current will reach here, so see, since all the resistors are of same value, so here it will be I by 2 and here also it will be I 2. Current gets equally divided. Now come to this branch. So this I amount of current will come to the point number 2. So again it will find branch, and since resistors are same, so equal amount of current, that is I by 2 current, will flow from 2 to 3 and 2 to 5. Same thing is here. Now come to the point 8. So I by 2 current is coming here and I by 2 current is coming from this branch. So you will get I current in the branch 8 to 7. And same thing is for branch 3 to 7, and same for C 5 to 6 and 2 to 6. Means whole circuit is symmetric here. Now apply Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's voltage law, actually, in a loop. So which loop I am selecting? 1 to 4 to 3 to 7 and then V to 1. So let me write in loop 1, 4, 3, 7, then V, means from this wire, okay, and then again 1. So let's apply. So 1 to 4 IR and 4 to 3 means, see, I by 2 current is flowing from in the branch 4 to 3. So plus I by 2, okay, then 3 to 7, so plus yahan par R rahega, plus I R, ab 7 pe pahunch gaye, after 7 we will come to negative terminal of battery, means minus V, okay, and then 0.1 is equal to 0, means loop completed. So it means I can write V is equal to IR plus IR plus I by 2R. So it means 2IR plus I by 2 into R. So this will give you what? 5IR, 2 to the 4 means 5IR divided by 2, okay, is V. Now what is V? According to Ohm's law, suppose R dash is the equivalent resistance. If R dash is equivalent resistance, just assume. So I can write I R dash is equal to 5 I R by 2. Okay. Now I means basically how much current we assume from the battery? So 3I. So I can write here 3I, actually, that is current into resistance. So see, 3I current is flowing. So from battery, that is the current we are talking about. So 3I into, don't get confused, this is Ohm's law applied, but actually mein ye 3I hai. So R dash is equal to 5 by 2I R. So I get cancelled, this 3 will go there. R dash is equal to 5 by 6 R. This is your answer. In few steps, you can solve this equation. Okay. Now, in next question. So this is the cube 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, and in question all have same resistors R, and we have to find out current between edges 1 and 3. ओके. सो 1 एंड 3 के बीच में हम लोग को पता करना है व्हाट इज द इफेक्टिव रेजिस्टेंस, टोटल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफर्ड बाय दिस सर्किट. नाउ इन दिस सर्किट सी, सपोज सम अमाउंट ऑफ करंट विल कम. सो दिस ब्रांच आर सेम, मीन्स 0.4 एंड 0.2 आर इक्विपोटेंशियल, बिकॉज सी हियर इट विल रीच टू द बैटरी, इवन दिस करंट विल रीच टू द बैटरी by covering same amount of resist. Okay, it means they are equipotential. Okay, so it means you can join them. Okay, so now I will tell you concept how to solve this. Now suppose if assume 1 ampere current is flowing, is coming from the battery, and then if suppose x amount of current will flow from 1 to 2, then same amount of current x will flow from 1 to 4. Okay, so therefore I can write 1 minus 2, sorry, 1 minus 2x current will flow from this branch. Okay, this is the concept, and in this how you can solve, by applying Kirchhoff's law, by selecting loop. Okay, so select any loop, like apply KBL in loop. Suppose I am giving a loop 1, 5, 6, 2, 1. Okay, then write Kirchhoff's law. Okay, so you will get equation in terms of x. Okay, and let me give you direction. Now see, if suppose for an example, at this point again this x amount of current will get divided, and even at this point okay, then now suppose I will take y amount of current is going from this branch. So x minus y amount of current will go from this branch. It means even from this branch, y amount of current will flow. So x minus y amount of current will flow from this branch. Now at this point, 1 minus 2x amount of current is coming. And now suppose z amount of current will go here. Suppose z amount of current will go. Okay, then it means how much current flow between 5 to 8? 1 minus 2x minus z. And from this branch, now see, x minus y is going in this direction, and 1 minus 2x minus z will go in this direction if they will come here. So means from this 8 to 7, how much amount current will flow? X minus y plus 1 minus 2x minus z amount of current will flow in between this equation. Then this much amount will come here, and this x minus y and plus z will flow from x minus y plus z. Itna current is branch to flow over. Now by applying Kirchhoff's law, you have to make two equations, find out the value of x and y. Now students, see, if suppose you want to find out voltage across 1 and 3, okay, so V13 basically is nothing but V1 to 2 plus V1 to 3. Okay, so if we'll find out value of x, okay, so you can, that is the value of current, so I and resistance you know, plus V13, if you know the value of y, so what you can do, V equal to value of y into value of R. So you will get basically this I R equivalent is equal to, okay, V12 plus V13, and put the value of x and y, so you will get one side I R dash and one side equation in terms of numerical value of x and y and R. So you push to cut pit hoga, or you will get value of resistance. So this is basically एक लूप आपको 15621 लेना है, 15621, और एक जो है बेस ले लो 14321, सेकेंड लूप, दिस यू हैव टू सॉल्व, सेकेंड लूप 14321, ओके। दो इक्वेशन बनाओ बाय मेकिंग टू इक्वेशन, फाइंड आउट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई एंड यूज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, यू विल गेट आंसर ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस बिटवीन पॉइंट ए एंड बी, ओके। ओके, वॉट एवर मेथड आई एक्सप्लेन टू सॉल्व दिस कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सर्किट, इट वॉज बेसिकली ट्रेडिशनल मेथड बाय अप्लाइंग किरचॉफ्स लॉ फॉर बोर्ड एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, ओके। बट इन कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम लाइक IIT, JEE, NEET, इन दिस एग्जाम इट विल सॉल्व बाई यूजिंग दिस मेथड, सो इट विल टेक मच टाइम टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशंस, ओके। सो यू विल you may lose many questions because of this traditional method. So what I will do, there is one shortcut also, let me make the diagram. Suppose this is the cube, so you can remember very easily, easy mnemonics, and you can find out values, okay. Now numbering, this was number one, point number one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. So first we found between 1 to 2. What is equivalent resistance between 1 to 2? Okay. इसको कहते हैं edge. Equivalent resistance in cube along edges. Edge, okay. Then we found equivalent resistance between 1 and 3, which is called face, along the face, face diagonal, okay. Suppose I will write it F, face diagonal. And then we found between 1 to 7 equivalent resistance, this is called body diagonal, means body ke through hote hue diagonal. See, there are two diagonals, one diagonal here or one diagonal here, 1 to 7, 1 to 3, 1 to 7, both are diagonal. Okay, but this is called face diagonal, okay, and this is called body diagonal. So suppose this is body diagonal, okay. Chalo isko se divide kar dete hain, okay. Ab yahan par sabse pehle aapko aise ek ek line khichna hai, isko aap yaad kar sakte ho, email or Facebook, aisa Facebook electronic aisa kuch mnemonic deke aap yaad kar sakte ho isko. It is very easy, and I say then you have to write here 1, 2 denominator mein, and then 3, 4, and then we have 5, 6, and here 7, means 1, 2, then 3 by 4, then 5 by 6, then 7. So in this shortcut method you can, so kisi bhi edges par, suppose 8 टू 7 बोला, तो जो 1 टू 2 है, 1 टू 2 वही उतना ही रेजिस्टेंस का वैल्यू 8 टू 7 भी होगा. अगर 8 टू 4 बोलता है तो ये फेस डायगोनल हो जाएगा, तो आपको हमेशा 3/4 ही मिलेगा. अगर 8 टू 2 इफ दे आर आस्किंग टोटल इफेक्टिव रेजिस्टेंस, यू विल गेट 5/6. सो लाइक दिस यू कैन रिमेंबर, एंड इन वेरी शॉर्ट यू कैन सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन ऑन दिस रजिस्टर. नाउ अनदर मेथड इज ऑल्सो देयर, वीडियो बहुत बड़ा हो जाएगा, और you can find out equipotential points, and if they are equipotential you can join both the wires, okay. So you can join means, so by simplifying that circuit you can solve the problem, okay. That method I'll explain in next video, and thank you so much for watching.